We welcome you to join us in a series of videos we're going to be producing about our twin boys. Why is it a series? It's just because there's so much to share with you, what we went through before their birth, during the birth, and what happened after that. There were so many challenges, but in the midst of it all, Jesus has been so faithful. We can't help but share with you the mighty things that he's done in their lives. We just celebrated their fourth birthday just a few days back, and what a wonderful birthday gift for them when they grow up, that they would see the things Jesus has done for them. So we welcome you to join us. Please watch all of the videos and share it with your family and friends. And our desire is that Jesus will become so real to you, his power, his love, his might, and his faithfulness, so that if you are going through challenges, you will know and be encouraged that you can trust in Jesus, who is so faithful. For purposes of full disclosure, I should also say that if you're a mother who's expecting and are pregnant, please use your own discretion as you deem appropriate if you would like to watch it, simply because we're going into some of the complications of pregnancy, as my wife went through, as well as during and post-birth phases. So you use your discretion. However, if you're parents and you're going through different challenges, it may not be the ones that we've went through, but we want to just encourage you, watch it and let Jesus bless you and open your eyes so that he'll become so real to you. May this encourage you. God bless you.
I had to pump milk at the nights, yeah.
So you were sleeping very less?
I was sleeping less anyway, yeah.
And then she let you sleep, right?
She came, yeah, and I could sleep in the day for some hours. Yeah, that was helping.
Yeah, that was really helping. So sweet, yes. So sweet. Yeah. So thank you for your selfless help driving all the way. It was in winter, it wasn't easy, and coming all the way to help us out. Million thanks. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it. And you know, kids, I'm talking to my kids, when you all see this video later in life, learn to appreciate first and foremost Jesus. Amen. Now I'm talking to nobody else, but our children will watch these videos. My precious children, learn to honor Jesus. Mm. Don't take him for granted. Learn to honor my Jesus. He means so much to me. He means so much. My Jesus means a lot to me, kids. He means everything. He's my everything. He is my everything. Mm. Just learn to honor my Jesus. Mm. Learn to keep him first in your life.
Amen.
He is my life. He is my everything. Mm. Learn to honor him first. Mm. Next, don't ever take him for granted. Mm. Be ready to give your life for him. He gave us his. Mm. And then learn to be grateful for people who have been there during our tough times. Mm. It was not necessary for them to help, but they did.
Yeah.
Learn to honor the people who've been there for us. Whether it was physical support, I'm literally talking to our kids who would watch this when they grow up. Mm. Whether it was physical support or in prayer, each of them are valuable. Nothing is more important than the others, right? Everything was equally important. Those who helped us in being there for you and for our daughter, in whichever way, even if it was just a little WhatsApp message, learn to honor the people who've been there during our tough times. Mm. Never forget them. Never forget it. And be there to help them when they need it. And always realize we are connected first to Jesus, then we are connected to one another in the body of Christ.
Amen. Yeah.
Always remember that. And learn to reveal Jesus in and through your lives. Never take your lives for granted.
Yes.
You're so precious to us. That's why I can't help but tell you, never take your life for granted. There's so much that's been poured into your lives. Learn to glorify Jesus. Never compromise with this world, with the values of this world. Let the Word of God, let the Word of God be your guiding factor. Always, the Word of God is a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path. And the one who will help that Word become life to you is the precious Holy Spirit. Mm. I just want you to know, my children, Darling, we didn't plan on telling this, yeah?
Mm.
But I'm just telling you because this specific part of the video is for you all. My precious children, listen to me. Listen to your father and mother. When I proposed to your mama, long back, 2010 of August, when I proposed to her, it was the 28th of August, 2010. The first thing I asked your mama was, will you marry me, right, in German? We will tell you when you grow up how I did it, if you all want to know that, that is. But there were two questions I asked her, okay? Two, not one. One is, of course, right, if you will marry me, isn't it, darling? Because that's important to know.
Yes.
But the other thing I asked her in the same vein, is this. I asked her, in our life, I want to know if you are willing and ready to make every decision. I don't have the Bible here with me, but I had the Bible then with me. And I said, are you willing in our life together to make every decision based on the Word of God, which is the Bible? That is very important for me because it's not going to be my opinion. It's not going to be me telling anyone what to do. It's not going to be you telling anyone what to do. It's not going to be any human being who's going to dictate terms in terms of what and how our decisions are going to be framed and what influences our decision. But it's going to be the Word of God. I asked you, darling, are you going to be completely committed that the Word of God is going to be the guiding factor based on which every decision is going to be made?
Yeah.
And she said, you know, you said, for sure, I will not forget it. The first question, I wanted to impress her, you know, so I asked in German, Möchtest du mich heiraten? And then, okay, I'm not going to get into that, but I asked her that, and you, but the second one was equally important for me, so I asked her that in English, and I said, and she said, for sure, that's when, for me, we were engaged. And then we both knelt down and gave our life to Jesus and said, Jesus, you heard it. She said she will be my wife. And she also said, for sure, so that the Word of God is going to be the basis on which we'll make every decision. Why? Because Jesus said in Matthew 7, if you build your house on the rock, who's the rock? Jesus. Who is he? He's the living Word.
Amen.
How does he reveal himself? Based on the Word. That's what the Bible says. The Word of God is the lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. How wonderful. That's what he's given us to help us in this life. And he's given us the Holy Spirit to make that Word real to us. You want your house to stand, your home to stand. There will be storms that hit every home in life. No one can say they can never experience challenges. There'll be the way the storm manifests is going to be different. It's just going to be different storms to different people. But storms will come. But what makes it stand is going to be decisions that are going to be made. And if it's going to be made based on the Bible, the Word of God, based on the revelation of Jesus,
Amen.
Your house will stand.
Amen. Yeah.
That's what the Bible teaches, not my opinion. So it was important for me that I'm not going to be leading a home based on my opinions or based on my wife's opinion. How terrible it would be if a human being is going to make decisions, whether it's me or you, who doesn't even know the future. How wonderful it would be when we depend on the Word of God.
Yeah.
And she said, for sure, and by the grace of God, my sweetie, thank you, that by the grace of God, she has been true to that commitment. And by the grace of God, I hope I have been true to that commitment. Have I?
Yes, by God's grace.
Okay, if not, I would really need to ask the Lord's grace. But I think, and she says yes, but I think I do my best to ask the Lord's grace so that we make our decisions based on the Bible. Every decision we ask, this is what we do, and I'm speaking still to my children. So children, remember, every decision you make, when you do it based on the Word of God, which is a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path, and depend on the Holy Spirit who will make that word real to you and give you the right word at the right time to help you in your decisions, you will never go wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever the storm, storms will come, but in the midst of it, you will stand strong.
Amen. Yeah.
And that will be my prayer and desire for you.
Mm-hmm.
So first, be connected to Jesus. Love Him.
Yeah.
Love Him with all your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Be connected to God's people and love them.
Mm-hmm.
And next, depend on the Word of God and the Holy Spirit in every decision. They are faithful to lead you.
Mm-hmm.
Always.
Amen.
All right. Now let's get back talking to the people. All right. So, I'm also grateful in the midst of these help that we received from this family and prayer from so many other people that my boss confirmed I don't need to travel, you know, because I travel a lot for my work.
Yeah.
Now we are in Corona times, so obviously no one can travel much. So it's very restricted. However, at that time I used to travel a lot.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm so grateful for favor at work that I didn't need to travel.
Mm.
I know my wife is a little tired. It's really late in the night, you know, because of being hectic. Our life is rather hectic, so we decided just do it when our kids are asleep.
Yeah.
It's close to 11 in the night, but we just wanted to get through the series of videos. So I understand, darling, it's late. But that's something I'm grateful for as well. In the midst of these challenges, so the boys were out of ICU, remember, and then they were in the premature station. Now they were also out of that and they were transferred to another hospital which took care of children.
Because they needed space in that hospital where the,
children
were born.
Premature
cases because they had many children coming there,
What happened here was Nathaniel, right? Now he underwent a challenge.
Mm.
So what happened? You want to talk about that? So he had this
RS. So they were there, I think almost for 2 months they were there.
Mm-hmm.
And just 2 weeks, I think, before they had to come out or something, they got in that hospital. They had this RS virus, that is like a cold virus, but for these little ones, it is very risky. So, they
became serious.
Yeah, and that was one of these days when I really became again sad. And I remember we went to church that day after visiting the boys in the morning.
Yeah,
we had church in the afternoon.
You broke down, I remember.
And our friend from church, she came and hugged me and gave me a tissue because I just started crying because I felt so helpless. And I was very sad to see that step going back again, because Nathaniel and Philip, I don't know, but Nathaniel, he had to get this oxygen mask.
Yeah, seeing those coming back
so
on the boys,
he couldn't breathe enough himself. I mean, he didn't get enough oxygen himself because of this phlegm and that virus and bacteria or whatever was going on in the in his
nose.
Body.
Yeah.
And
also,
I was really that
antibiotics
was, that came
head.
Then also, then they told they have to give antibiotics, so they put it in the veins in the head. It looked really dangerous. I mean, that is normal to do that, it seems, but they had this injection with the antibiotic here in the head vein, and when we took them out on our chest, when we were allowed after a few days, and the head is still in their head here, and you had to be very careful.
It's really difficult to see that.
But what was really sad for me was because since the birth of the boys, we always saw
an improvement,
step by step. In Philip's life. Though we had again new challenges and all that, but there was always an improvement and not going back. And that time it was actually, as everything was fine and they come out soon and
this is again another big
then it
hit.
Was a really big hit, and I was a little broken, to be honest.
The doctor
it was
said he
difficult
became
for me because for Nathaniel, they said that this
became very weak.
Weak, yeah. He became very weak. Philip, by God's grace, he was much stronger that time.
Yeah.
And he didn't need to have that oxygen mask.
Mm.
Though he also got this virus, he also didn't feel so well. But he was much stronger. And till these days, I must really testify, by God's grace, our boys are really not much sick. They don't have even a cold or something the last year, I think, or 1.5 years.
Thank God.
And what I want to say is the Lord is really great and mighty. And
amen.
From all our three children, Philip is the one who is the strongest and who is, if there is a cold or something, I mean, you know it, then usually it goes to the other brother, to the other sister, and then also the parents usually get sometimes. So Philip is so strong, and for him it is over very soon, and he doesn't have such a struggle. And I mean, it's really, I want to just testify, because the Lord is such great and mighty God, and Philip is the strongest in our family now by God's grace. And but that time, Nathaniel became so weak, and there was even a risk that he had to go back to another hospital.
ICU,
And we could see that with other children, which had to go back to another ICU, and they were really again in life danger. And Nathaniel was actually fine all the time, only on this last 2 weeks then that happened to him, and that was really, I felt very, very
It was really difficult, I know, I know. I thought, oh, Nathaniel was good all the time, why did this happen now? And because they said he became extremely weak, that's why it was difficult. And then, remember, we came out of the hospital, and then he reached his arms and started crying.
Yes, one day, I have a photo of that. Yes. We had to go home, and he was looking like that.
He started weeping and he stretched his arms towards us.
Oh, it was...
He said it was...